So, yeah, session limits are the new normal if you're coding with AI agents, right? It's wild how much has shifted. Codex, the same one you can now use with your ChatGPT Plus or Pro plan, has its own set of limits. And honestly, it's something I wish I'd paid closer attention to before my last big sprint. If you're solo, bouncing between VS Code, Cursor, or even Windsurf, these limits can sneak up on you way faster than you'd think. Just real quick, I'm Daniel. I've been in the iOS trenches for 8 years now. Started out freelancing, helping clients ship their ideas, learning the hard way what actually works and what just burns you out. But after DubDub25, I went all in on solo dev. Since then, I've shipped a bunch of my own apps, started building everything out in public, and lately, Crafters Lab is where I've been putting all my energy. It isn't just another tutorial site or Discord to scroll past. This is my real home base for solo devs who treat AI like a teammate, not just a vending machine. Every deep dive guide, app blueprint, design workflow, even the exact Notion team spaces I use daily, they're all live here. Swift Brain, the full agents ops, and even my own playbook with real MD files. It's all finally in one place on a private indie first platform. If you want real systems, real code, and a real community for solo devs, not just another AI clone farm, that's what I'm building. And yeah, if you're part of the Patreon crew, huge thanks. And heads up, everything's moving over to crafterslab.dev. Okay, so yeah. Here's the thing about Codex limits. They're not just some theoretical ceiling you'll never reach. It's kind of wild. You send a few local prompts, maybe run a couple cloud jobs, and you think, eh, no big deal. But the truth is, every single thing you do, whether it's a little script, a big batch refactor, or even just asking Codex to hold a ton of context in a session, it's all quietly eating into your plan. And you know, it's not just about hammering local messages in VS Code or Cursor. Every cloud task counts too, even if it feels like magic for now. And right, cloud is free until October 20th, but that window's closing soon. If you're on Plus, you might get 30 to 150 local messages or a handful of cloud jobs in a 5 hour block. On Pro, it's a much bigger playground, but still 300 to 1,000. 500 locals or 50 to 400 clouds. And honestly, a gnarly build or a bunch of migrations will chew through that faster than you think. What really gets me is how it's all shared. It doesn't matter if you're hacking in the CLI, jumping into Cursor, or letting Codex do the heavy lifting in Windsurf, it's all drawing from the same pool. So I don't know, you ever feel like you're saving time by spreading tasks across tools, but then suddenly you're staring at a usage wall? Same. For me, I had to stop treating Codex like an always-on copilot. I plan out my heaviest jobs, batch them, and honestly, I've started keeping a little tally of what I send to the cloud just so I don't get caught off guard, because nothing sucks more than waking up mid-launch week to that usage limit hit message. And realizing, yeah, you used it all on a few marathon sessions without even noticing. Yeah, so this is the part nobody wants to deal with, right? You're cruising through a build, you're finally in that flow, and then out of nowhere, Codex just hard stops you. There's no, hey, slow down warning. It's just locked until that usage window resets. And honestly, it feels brutal the first time. No quick fixes, no PR reviews, no sneaky CLI hack. You're just out. I mean, yeah, you could use an API key and pay for extra runs, but for most solo devs, you just gotta wait it out. It's humbling, not gonna lie. My first instinct was to scramble, try every trick, but it turns out that's just wasted energy. What actually helps? Start batching more. Treat your Codex time like a block. Get all the heavy stuff in one session. Save the quick asks for later. And of course, watch out for those one-off fixes that eat up more than you expect. Oh, and if you're leaning hard on code review, just know personal PR reviews are free for now, but that's not forever. So don't get too comfortable with that loophole. Honestly, once I leaned into the rhythm, it got easier. I batch my sprints, take breaks when Codex locks me out, and every time I come back, I'm a little sharper. Plus, I'm not burning my whole allowance on throwaway prompts. It's not perfect, but it's way more sustainable than trying to brute force the limits. Okay, so let's be real for a sec. Everyone wants to know which one's tougher, right? Claude Code or Codex? And yeah, the answer is, it kind of depends how you work. With Claude Code, you're on the 5-hour session train. You get a set number of messages or prompts per session, and the clock's ticking the second you start. If you work in big focused blocks, you can get a ton done in a single session, but if you dip in and out, you'll burn sessions crazy fast, even on tiny follow-ups. And once you hit your session cap, especially on max plans, you're done. No wiggle room. Codex, on the other hand, gives you a pool. It's about how many local or cloud tasks you can run in a given window. There's a weekly cap, but it also tracks every 5-hour chunk. And here's the wild part. Every little task, whether it's a tiny script or a huge migration, pulls from the same allowance. So it can feel generous on the surface, but if you run a bunch of big jobs or have Codex handle complex context, you'll hit that wall sooner than you think. Plus, it doesn't matter if you're working in Cursor, VS Code, or the CLI. It all adds up in the same bucket. So what does this actually mean if you're building solo? For me, Claude Code kind of trains you to batch. You sit down, clear your list, work deep. With Codex, it feels more like managing a budget. You've got to keep an eye on your running total or risk getting cut off in the middle of something important. Both systems can punish scatter. If you're the type to bounce between tasks or send a million little prompts, you'll burn out your quota no matter which agent you use. And honestly, neither one is unlimited. They both want you to be deliberate, to treat each block like it's your only shot, and I'll say it, to work a little smarter, not just harder. If you're building features, debugging, or shipping for real, these limits will push you to prep, batch, and get intentional, which honestly has made my own workflow way sharper than before. So yeah, whether you're a Claude Code person, a Codex fan, or like me, just jumping between whatever works, these new rules change the game. The trick isn't picking the looser tool. It's learning how to work with the limits, not against them. So yeah, Codex session limits aren't just some fine print. They're real, and you're gonna run into them if you're building solo with AI, probably sooner than you think. But honestly, if you treat every block like it matters, batch your deep work, and don't waste your best energy on throwaway prompts, you'll get way more from every plan. If you found this useful, or you've got your own Codex story, the good, the bad, or the slightly chaotic, drop it in the comments. I read everyone, and honestly, swapping workflow tips is half the fun of this whole thing. And if you're looking for real-world indie workflows, step-by-step guides, and a community that actually cares about building, not just shipping clones, check out crafterslab.dev. That's where I'm sharing all my best stuff, from deep dive Notion setups to agent ready docs, and it's only getting better. Until next time, keep crafting, keep learning, and don't let a usage limit kill your momentum. Catch you in the next one. Peace.